Hello again, this is Kent. I hope you're having a good day. We are in the video I'm making right now, Inkscape Tutorials for Beginners series, and we're at number 14, the last one for this series, and this is about selecting objects under other objects and dragging a selection. First off, I want to show you that there is an object under here. It has its exact same size circle. I duplicated the one underneath and made what you see on top. The one underneath is red. And to show you that, I'm going to hit the shift and arrow button on my keyboard. Hold down the shift and then hit the arrow, right arrow. You see the red on the bottom? One, two, three. There you go. There is something below there. There is an object below the top, the circle below the blue circle. And so how do we select the one underneath? So if you're in a drawing, you don't want to be messing things up by moving this over here. You don't want to do that because you're just messing up your whole drawing, and you don't want to keep on figuring out, let's get this back to where it was before and try to move this, and just takes up time. So what you want to do is you hold down your Alt key and then you click with your left button on your mouse. There, the blue one is now selected. To get the one underneath selected, all you do is you click again in the same wherever in the same area. And right now you see the fill is blue, and so we have the top one selected. If I click again with my Alt key down and the left button on my mouse, the fill change, and that's because the bottom is selected. And to show you and prove that, I'll hit the shift arrow key on my keyboard. Hold down the shift and then the arrow key, right arrow key. And there you see the red one moving because that's the one that's selected. Okay. I might add that, I am using a Windows machine, and if you are using Linux, this might not work for you because you need to make some adjustments to your window manager. So keep that in mind, or your window behavior configuration might be needing adjustment. Also, now, whenever you have, let me do something else. Let me actually put something over, and I'll change the color. Then also make it transparent so you can see those items. But let me. Yeah, I don't always use this myself, so okay, so I'll hit Alt click, and I clicked on the blue one, the blue circle. I'll hit Alt click again, and now the red is selected, as you see down here in the fill. So to move that, you just keep your Alt key down, held down, and you just drag. You just click inside where you know the circle, the red circle is, and you drag. Okay. Now I can click Alt click again, or do Alt click, and it'll this the rectangle will be selected, which is actually on top. And I can click Alt click again, and then I can drag this by just keeping my Alt key down on my keyboard and then dragging with my mouse. Okay. Hey, after the video, I decided I needed to come back and show you something else about editing items that are below other items. And to do that, I put a path, or it's actually from the pen tool or Bezier tool, underneath this rectangle. So this as you see, I cannot click this path at all. I can't click the circles, of course, either, without hitting the Alt key. Now, when I hit the Alt or hold down the Alt key, I can click the circles. Now, remember, you have to click on the over the item to actually select it. So right now, I'm clicking with the Alt key down, and it's bouncing back between the blue circle and the rectangle. That's because I'm not even over the red circle at all. I'm over the red circle, and now it's selecting each of the three items one after another. Now if I click over the path, then I can actually select it. And you can go up to the node, the edit paths node tool, either, or you can hit F2 and click on that while your path is selected or your circle is selected. Hold down your Alt key and you can move it, manipulate or edit this path. Now I can go back and I can select circle, and I can do the same thing. And you can double click there. And then I can change the circle also. Okay? That's it. Thanks. I hope you liked this video. If you do, please like it on YouTube. And also, if you do want to see other videos, maybe some advanced videos where we're actually making a drawing or something, or looking at other features of Inkscape, please subscribe. Thank you very much. This is Kent from SimpleTutorials.net. Thank you.